YouTube fans, here again. And I think as I did it before, the best films of 1989, meaning my favourite films of 1989, part two. That's right, part two, why not, why not? So first of all, I do die this one for size. See no evil, hear no evil. This is a film now I cry. I cry a lot because basically you're missing two very, very funny people, that being Richard Pryor, and the other one being T. Wilder. Now, we always remember them in 1980 in the Tacit film being Sturtezer. And yes, before Sturtezer, they did other comedies, did Deffer as well. But you know, the bid it had to be Sturtezer. So it took them like this, and I mean this, to star in another film to Deffer. So See No Evil, Hear No Evil was a bid it comedy in its day. But like most things in that era, it got a lot of stick. A lot of people said they were making fun of people with disabilities and all this. And I'm sorry, right, because people say that, I've got to disagree. If people bother to watch this film proper, you find really they was making fun of the people who were ignorant of the people who've got disabilities, whether you're blind, whether you're deaf. That's what See No Evil did, and it was funny. And it was like a detective, it was like a witness to a murder and all this, and I like that. It was a good story, it was funny. I like See No Evil, Hear No Evil, so fuck it. I love it. Another one which never gets mentioned anymore. Never gets mentioned. And what's so heartbreaking is they've never made a DVD or a Blu-ray of this. And it's terminal. That being Lung Einstein. Come out in 1989. Just like See No Evil, Hear No Evil. Very proper. So why the hell it's not on DVD and Blu-ray? I do not know. They can waste money on 100 Days of Sorrow on a fucking Blu-ray and a DVD, which is fucking terminal, because that to me is torture porn. But hey, we can't waste money on fucking Lung Einstein. No. We can't waste money on that, which was a popular film in its day. So I like that one. It's very clever. It's a comedy. It's based on the olden times. It's how Einstein gets to be Einstein. Yeah, it's Australian, but it's a good one, and it's funny. And it's very creative, very teffer, very imaginative, big word for me. So why not about a two? Lung Einstein. And try this one on for size. Who are you? I'm Batman. That's why I'm Batman. I'm not sure I've done it already in the first one. But we all know Batman was a big hit film. Dad Michael Keaton. Yeah, I know a lot of people were hesitant over Michael Keaton because he was a comedy star. But they took him on after Beetlejuice and he proved he was a good Batman. I think Jack Nicholson proved he was a good Joker. I like the Bat-Town story. Okay, he's not as faithful to the comic as people thought it was going to be, but the comic was a hell of a lot of fun in the days. But I like it. I thought it was very good. I liked Jim Basinger, it's Vicky Vale. I like the songs sang by Prince. So, without ado, Batman. Biggest dosing film of 1989, but that wasn't only the biggest one of 89. Think of this one, Honey, We Shrunk the Chicks. That's right, for once Walt Disney did a good film, that being Honey, I Shrunk the Chicks. Practical effects, something very rare, won an award, very popular, and I like that. So Honey, I Shrunk the Chicks, definitely sunk on me. And then we go on to other date films of the golden era of 1989. Why not, why not? So we go through Xanathin, very hard film people never know about. If you don't know what Xanathin is, think of Robocop star Peter Weller. Kind of a cheesy feature film. If it's one of them you like Alien, you're going to love it. If you like films like The Abyss, you're going to love it. It's like, what would happen if The Abyss meets Alien on the way? You had a lot of good actors, very well done tasks, a very good story. Again, very hard to see these days, practical effects. Brilliant. And then they had another film in 1989. They made a lot of underwater films in that day when you think about it. That being Deep Star 6. Again, cheats of feats are underwater, it's a monster attacking people, and I love it. But then we get the proper underwater film. Well, it turned out it wasn't a cheats of feats film, that being The Abyss. I've seen them both. I saw the one after in the early 90s. Being a director's cut, with a few altered little bits here and there, and a bit at the end of the deleted ending. But whichever one you like, I still love The Abyss. It's underwater, it's dark, you've got good actors. acting, something very rare you see these days. Yes, this is CTR, very early CTR, but this CTR worked. It worked for what they had to do, and that, and the fact they did it all in a tank. None of it, well, it was underwater, but it wasn't under the ocean that it was made out to be. It was actually in a big tank. David Tamlin did another good film after his big success of The Exterminator, and Double Dead before Exterminator 2, so to say The Exterminator, and the big success of Aliens. He made another good one, and not a lot of people talk about it now. The Abyss. Not a lot of people talk about it, and it's terminal, but it's a dud one. I'm happy to say now they bought it out on 4K, and maybe around the road I might update to a 4K. For the moment, I'm happy where I am. But that being The Abyss. So that's another one from 1989. Would have to be my favourite, Matt Doden there of 1989. Then I think another one's on the way. Let me think. Can't think of it now. It's not like old Blue Steel. It's fair, Blue Teen Cop. Now, Blue Teen Cop is a film with Jamie Lee Curtis. Very, very good story. It's about Jamie Lee Curtis. She's a cop. And Blue Teen's cop. Remember, I think I'm wrong on the name. And she meets this guy. She falls for him. Long and behold, he's a psychopath. You've never seen Blue Steel's drop, and you're sick of seeing Jamie Lee Curtis being in every fucking remake, reimagining of Halloween these days. What's Jamie Lee Curtis when she was in her best? The performance is brilliant in this. It's a thriller. It's psychological. It's disturbing, but not too much. It's suspenseful. Blue Steel's top. Damn good film. So that came out in my favourite there, being 1989. And like I say, 1989, they made a load, I mean, back in loads of damn good films. They made loads of damn good films. I'm not sure if I added Batman in the first one. I might have forgotten, but if I did, it was a big film. What can I say? Let me think of other ones on the way. Because like I say, in 1989, they made loads of big films of 1989. They made fucking loads. So it's a hard one. You know, I said it already. I'll say a few what I didn't like, weren't my favourite. Why not? Tragic Kid Fee, I thought was weak. They turned Daniel's son into a fucking wimp. After seeing him in the first one, fair enough, he didn't know anything about Tarate. Then he meets that guy, the Chinese guy, teaches him fucking Tarate. Tragic Kid 2, he goes all the way to China and he fights a guy to the death, but just because it's PT, it doesn't so fight to the death, so instead you get beep. Then Tragic Kid Fee, turn him into a fucking wimp. A fucking wimp again. I don't get it. After fighting someone to the death in Tragic Kid 2 and going beep and winning the fight by a sneaky move in the original, just for them to not know anything about fucking Tarate. Somebody kick me in the fucking head, give me a fucking break. And at the end, he just wins by luck. By luck. And it's sad. So that one was my favourite. If I want to watch Tragic Kid, I watch the original. They made it up, that's a remake. Before a remake. The second one, I like the song in it, but it's not in 89, so I think that had to be the weakest of films from that era. Had to be. But there was other films I like, you know, you had K-9, you had Wolverine and Oots, which is similar to K-9, with Tom Hanks. But that a few big films from that golden year of 1989. So it was a dud day, it was a dud era. They made loads, and it's like I said before, without repeating myself, there were no fucking remakes, there were no shit re-shittenings, comedies were funny. You had the Deliverance, if I pronounce that right. I've got might be one there about the very first film that Charlie Munro did. This was after a music career, after the Bid It Aussie Soap being Neighbours. She did a first feature film being Deliverance, which really sums up the 50s of how stupid people were, and you really felt for that character. Damn good acting role by Tyler Monroe. And let me think of other dud films from that golden there. A Innocent Man by Tom Selleck. You want to see Tom Selleck after Magnum PI do a really good acting role? What's A Innocent Man? About a man who gets wrongly, I remember reviewing this film by the way, about a man who gets wrongly accused, goes to prison, didn't do anything, as innocent as anything, and he goes after the ones that set him up. Very good performance. And again, prison films. You had Lock Up in 1989, Sylvester Stallone, damn good performance. Same there, Tango and Tass, with Kurt Russell and Sylvester Stallone. So the list goes on. The list goes on of 89. So that'll be part two of 89. If I think of others, I'll probably do a part three. But I think I summed up with one of my favourite films from that golden year, being 1989. But into them, be smart, be safe. See you later.